There was a time when the sun got tired of the idiocy of humans and decided to hide and never rise again. Eventually, I saw the zombies coming out of their graves, and war broke out between the living and the dead. There was little light left, and it was barely enough to go around. Humans had a boss in whom they believed as one of these in God. His niece, Nina. Luckily for us, she was different from all the other humans. She liked to play near the water, and maybe she knew the sun was hiding down there. But what do I know? I'm just a gravekeeper. It's Gloomy. I buried this boy. No one came to the funeral. He was different from all the other zombies. We all missed the sun. We thought watching this film was helpful, but it made us miss it more. Even though Gloomy seemed harmless, he got hungry sometimes. She lost her dog many times a day, and each time she missed it more. For the uncle, the most important thing was to hunt zombies. And not waste time with dogs and body parts. In his belly. The sun was hiding, but something in those two kids made him feel he could rise again from the darkness. How would it be to feel the light of the sun for the first time? Gloomy couldn't forget what he had seen in the water. The sun, the first light. He was longing to see Nina again. To tell her what he saw. So he built a tiny sun for her. Nina lived with her uncle, who had rescued her. Sometimes she feared him, but sometimes, well, he was just her uncle. Nevertheless, in that big house, she had created her own little world. Cold night, a dark park, but they were together again. For their first date, the sun offered them some playful light. Nina and Gloomy were the same age, but she was much more adventurous. Thank you. The uncle convinced the people that the zombies were a threat to humanity. And as such, they must be thrown away. This town was made only for the living. As it always happened on the full moon, the whole town went out hunting zombies. They locked them into cages and threw them far away. But that night, the uncle was after one particular zombie. When they were together, no dark was dark enough for them. They shined. And the sun felt complete when he didn't shine alone. Maybe if the humans had tolerated their love, things could have turned out another way. The sun couldn't bear the pain. When he saw Gloomy die, he felt he was finally dying too. A freezing darkness took over the world. I bury dead people. That's my job. But this kid, it wasn't the first time I put him underground. They told me to bury him far away, so that he would never return. The warmth of the sun was gone, and only the cold of death remained. The uncle had thrown all the zombies far, far away. There was not a single zombie around, but the world was still dying in its freezing darkness. It had been the first time Nina was in love, and it had been too short. As the world, her heart was falling apart. All Nina wanted was to see Gloomy again. This little dog loved two things above all else: being loyal to his friends and digging up their bones. Gloomy couldn't die, but something in him was definitely dead. The magic was gone, and he was completely blind. Nina wanted to go back to the last place where she saw the light in his eyes. Owls. They're often considered a symbol of wisdom, of guidance.
Bad time for mystical creatures. The uncle felt deeply irritated. He hated the idea of not knowing where Nina was. When he heard that Nina and Gloomy were back together, he exploded with rage. He unleashed his revenge. Nina had found the last warm place left. She seemed to know how to help Gloomy. It had a soothing effect on him. For a moment, they forgot what they were looking for. But playing has a strange way of making things work out. They finally found their friend, the sun. The revenge was on her way. The uncle had prepared the worst ending for Gloomy.
You're not entitled to the power. Not being started, not yet.
was willing to forget everything that had happened.
For the last time.